the Onyx from the Philippines, or is it going to be Onyx from Indonesia? Which one is it? Use their hashtags and support your favorite team as we land straight into the Land of Dom for our first match of Group B.
It's time, baby. Let's get it right here. Hashtag PH Pride or hashtag Indo Pride in the chat. I want everyone to go crazy. Show your support for your country, nationalism at its best, as we are going to see these titans collide in the first match of day number two.
So far, I mean, the game is starting off slow, but Drian immediately looking trying to punish Bloisky here, and it may not necessarily be a good idea to give them such an early level lead, especially since they haven't hit level two.
Absolutely. This is the power of Beatrix in the early game. She just does so much from terms of wave clear and in terms of basically fighting 1v1. Oh, but it's going to be CW! First blood by Razor! Super sharp, crisp gameplay from Marky already picking off the gold laner.
This is really interesting. I am getting the vibes that this is going to be an interesting matchup. I mean, Hatred playing Amon in that mid lane is strange enough, but it's going to be Boots and Dlarski, who's pretty much going to be an island on their own here.
Yeah, I agree. That's a 50-50 battle that will be just, you know, about clearing waves at this point. I was actually surprised that instead of going for the Paquito jungle, they went in for the Paquito gold lane. Now they match it up against the Lilia, which is even worse for the Paquito because just of the range and the burst damage. And I think that Onyx Esports might have overthought this. Maybe they are thinking that the Amon will be in the gold lane instead of the Lilia. If Lilia in the mid lane now, it's tricky because you have the Amon immediate burst against the eventually if he gets level 4, that's a big burst on the Beatrix, and Beatrix can't stop that. And on top lane, the combo of the Paquito can be easily be tanked up and soaked up by the Black Shoes, and Marky actually winning the battle up top.
Honestly, I think this is just really interesting. Initially, I thought Onyx PH was like, you know what, we have the Amon, you know, we've already got the Lilia as well. We can control the mid lane and maybe help out our Amon. But instead, they're like, no, we don't care about lane. We want to fight for lane dominance. Ooh. Oh my goodness, Bloisky almost getting one shot there.
Let's go. What happens here? It's going to be Sans popping the Entropy. Turtle will be taken away by Bloisky, though. It's going to be Kyrie jumping in. Sans going to be the target. T-Boy gets taken down. It is a 1-0 right now as Onyx Philippines have come out on top. CW, he's looking for the gang onto Hatred. A lot of damage has been placed, still stuck at 1 HP, and is able to survive. Onyx Philippines right now are still untouchable.
Ooh, really? Really? He survives 1 HP? All right. I mean, so far, as you mentioned, Onyx PH still with the lead 2-0. They've developed at least a 2K gold lead 2 minutes as they move into the third minute of the game. CW, he's just kind of stuck in this lane with this Lilia. He cannot outpush it for now, but now that he's level 4, he may have an opportunity here. Mid lane going to get opened up.
It is going to be opened up. Bloisky again, opening up the map really, really well. There's nothing Onyx Esports, Onyx ID can really do at this point to go and target this. Oh, Bloisky, maybe not actually. It's going to be Drian using ultimate, getting in, and a flicker to finally get a kill back onto Onyx Philippines. And guess what? Indonesia, they're on the board.
Oh, that was nasty. I mean, we had to move that out of the way. It was... The kids can't see that. The kids definitely cannot see that. We got to protect them while we still can. But now, this does open up the map a little bit more. They should be pointing towards this mid side, and immediately they do find Agent.
Ooh, whoa! Where did he go? I was going to throw it over, but he just instantly popped.
God, we were... I mean, you know what? Under to our convention center, we were talking about how the shotgun of Beatrix is not that good when it comes to teamfights, but look at that pickup. I mean, he just... was gone in a second.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, that's kind of what Amon's biggest weaknesses is. His base HP is really, really little, and the same can be said about Rafaelia, but let's see how they control it, because Onyx Esports, great control of mid lane. They're pressing it onto the top side.
Wait a minute, it's going to be Hatred jumping onto Keyboy, still has a flicker and is able to dodge away. Sans now gets caught in the Holy Baptism. Kyrie dashes in with a Thorn Rose. He's going to go for the kill, the Retribution, just a little bit more, but Sans somehow still survives. Miscalculations coming in from Kyrie, but it's okay. It is already very good setup for the Philippine side to take this second turtle. CW, though, he doesn't want to go for ways. He's going to be able to take that Black Boots away before the turtle fight starts, but there isn't going to be a turtle fight.
I love it. I love this early aggression coming in from Onyx PH, but Onyx Esports, they also know that they want to keep strong. The turtle slain. Oh my goodness. We got to thank the Singaporean Tourism Board for making this game happen here. Onyx PH and Onyx Esports, like, oh, God bless, God. God bless the fans raging in chat for the excitement of this game.
Man, you know, I'm looking at the chat. There are a lot of funny comments, but I think the number one, the most funny one is like, I hope Onyx wins. It's just so
I do hope that Onik wins too.
Oh, that's the greatest. That's the greatest. But now the next fight is already beginning. Sand starts the initiation as CW pushes them back. But Onik Philippines understands. Yeah, 4 against 3. Let's chill for a second, boys. It's the calm before the storm right now, right? Onik and Onik, both of them, they're playing it safe. They don't want to really go for aggressive plays before an objective spawns up. Dreon going in, trying to clear the little wanderer, knows that Hatred is in the bush, instantly just backs away. He has this shotgun to go for the wave clear, to go for this little wanderer. But Kyrie, he's going to jump in with a phantom execution, gets the thorn rose out, not going to be able to fish. And no, wait a minute. Kyrie keeps on going in. Sans goes in for the entropy, and there you go. CW out of nowhere catches a kill. And now it's going to be Kyrie on the next target. He's trying to run away, but in the end, it is just going to be a 1-0 for the side of Onik ID.
Ooh, fast fingers, but also just a great diversion coming in. As Onik Esports, they're like, okay, Onik DH is like, we're going to jump to your backline. We're going to try and take out your jungler. But Sans is like, nah. I want to take your support. I want to make sure I'm punishing this Amon. And even Keyboy finally catch up his.
Kyrie coming in. He's going to go for more. Dreon, he can't go anywhere. And that's going to be a double kill picked up for Kyrie. Looking for the triple kill. CW is nowhere to go. Will he get it? The triple kill for Kyrie.
That's showtime, Kyrie, that you're looking at. With that 3K, I'm actually wondering why he was so confident in playing that round. But he knows that Onik Esports has already blown all of their ultimates and that he has got the damage. He knows the Lancelot so much. And you know what they say? The last championship in the world stage was off of a Lancelot from the Philippines.
We gotta pay respects where respect is due, and you're absolutely right about that, Wolf. But I have to admit, like, RPH, they've got some really sick mechanics on their junglers. I think that is the staple point and one of the biggest factors that Philippines has going for them. But Onik Esports, you have to admit, their macro coordination is pretty good.
Yeah, Boloisky is gonna get chunked really, really low there, but the turtle is gonna be taken away by Kyrie. San's gonna be the target right now, get stunned up. Not a lot of damage to get him down, but Onik ID, they're gonna try. They're gonna go back instantly, just falling back. Don't want to commit onto a failed objective steal as CW as well, doing the same thing at that top side.
It's gonna be a tough matchup from here on out because now as we're slowly rotating into that make it. Wait, Keyboy.
Keyboy going in. He's gonna be able to get Boloisky out of the way, but it's gonna be Kyrie dashing back and forth. Sans gets chunked really low. It's gonna be Boot still running away. A lot of damage has been placed by Dreon, and both teams decide to back off once again. 0-4-0.
It's a good call. It's a really good call. But let's pull up the item list so far. Is there anything out of the ordinary here, Wolf?
Well, one thing is for sure. I mean, Marky is so rich right now with two items. Ice Queen 1 as well as the Enchanted Talisman. And look at Kyrie prioritizing the Malefic Roar over something like an Endless Battle or a Blade of Despair.
No, I think that's actually a really good idea because I think that Onik PH have identified that, like, yes, Onik Esports are kind of strong when it comes down to these bigger team fights. Maybe we can have a little bit of a, put some points in some split push, make sure to keep things open, look to kind of pick up the gold around the side lanes, and maybe to split Onik Esports apart.
Yeah, one thing that I did notice is that Boloisky picked up the Antique Arrest. That's why when he was gunned upon by Onik Esports, with the physical, majority of the damage of Onik Esports is physical, Onik PH survived that play.
Okay, Dlarski is going to get ganked, instantly just taken out right here. No response from Onik Philippines. Onik ID will be able to take a turret to equalize in this game. Still, right now, a 2,000 gold lead for the side of the Filipino representative. But Keyboy, he's going to look for Kyrie. Oh my god, what was that? He goes in and gets a kill. Boots is going to be next on the chopping block, still able to run away. Dreon, he's got to be careful. Kyrie's hungry, and he's going to jump in. Thorn Rose almost deletes Dreon from the Land of Dawn, but Onik ID will still be able to get out of that one. Not for long though. It's gonna be CW going for the knockoff strike, able to do some damage on the Hatred. Still able to run away for now. Keyboy gets chunked pretty low. Dreon goes in for the snipe. Not enough damage to take anyone down. It is a 1-0 for the side of Onik PH.
Wolf, you got some apologizing to do. Caster's Curse on Dlarsi. You're talking about him and giving like antique your ass, and then he gets dove by four people.
Exactly.
That is just ironic here. But now Turtle has turned into Lord right now. And so far with the energy shape plates already down, Onik Esports are losing turrets on the sides of the maps. Currently, Onik PH currently up when it comes down to these neutral objectives. But more importantly, it's about that control, right? Whoever breaks mid-tier one is going to have a great opportunity at choking out the jungle economy.
Yeah, it's almost a mirror matchup for both these teams. And when you're looking at an Onik Darby, you always have to look for the minimap. Because Boloisky, his positioning from the previous clash that Onik Philippines was able to win was off of him just hiding in there, just stunning Onik Esports, catching them off guard.
Onyx Philippines, they're taking this actually really, really fast. Boots, he's trying to open up the map, but it's gonna be the Lord taken away by Onyx Philippines. Onyx Esports, though, he's there looking for the fight. K-Boy goes in for a Tower's Revenge. Shutdown has been taken away, but look at Larski. He goes to the back lines and absolutely demolishes them. But CW, he's doing the same. And look at them on! The double kill picked up out of nowhere. CW and Boots, the side laners, all there is left, but Hatred will take the triple kill.
Oh my goodness, Boots! He fights one more. Mark, is he in trouble? Is he gonna die here?
He?
No! He pulls it off! He does it!
What the heck was that? Onyx Philippines, 4-2.
In the Philippines, this is what we call the Onyx magic. The way that they handle their mages is just so magical at this point. Look at Hatred. One shot for Hatred. The way that Kyrie actually dodged some of the skills because of the Thorn Rose. And you're gonna see the whole wraparound from Hatred. Both Sands as well as Drian were in the same spot. And you know that Amon, he loves that very, very tight corners. And look at that. I can't describe it. It's Onyx magic at this point.
It's great because both these Onyx, they're playing really similar games. They understand the backline is going to be a problem. They're going to have one side, one player dedicated to go back there from either one of these Onyx. So really, it's about the heroes and Amon is just great. Now Boots going to get attacked straight away.
A lot of resources have this bendo. It's going to be Sans going in and getting the kill onto Hatred. Although, look at the burst. Oh my lord. Marky's damage is disgusting. Almost one-shotting Sans.
They need to breathe here. I think, honestly, if you're an Onyx Esports from Indonesia, you need a little bit of a breather here. You need to be kind of slowing down that tempo against Onyx PH, who is pressing their lead against them. But the lead isn't that far apart. Yeah. You may be thinking 5K, but that's literally one team fight. Looking at the items here so far, what's the next step for Onyx Esports here, Wolf?
They need magic defense for now. As Onyx Philippines, they see Marky and Hatred, they're dealing so much damage. I mean, Kairi's a threat, but if you combine Marky and Hatred together, they're so strong as well.
Larski just takes so much damage with a vengeance on him, but it's gonna be Kyrie jumping to the backside, still able to deal some damage right there. As Onyx ID will choose to fall back from that one. Kyrie, he's really hungry for kills here. The disrespect already coming in, two levels ahead of Sans, and you can see the dominance at this point, man. 5 turrets to 1, 12 kills to 7, and that 7,000 gold lead.
I want to say for Onyx Esports, if they hang together, they have two marksmen in the late game. And no matter what happens, Keyboy's ultimate will be instrumental. If you're looking at Onyx Philippines, their cores, their gold lane, their mid lane, their jungler, they don't have Purify. And this ultimate from Keyboy combined with the burst damage from Drian as well as Sand's damage in the late game, that is something that Onyx Esports might go for.
I mean, we have to keep in mind that Loisky did take the Purify. He understands that with his ultimate, he might be able to save at least some of the key members of his team in these tight situations. Now, as we're coming back to the economy game here, Onyx Esports, yes, they are down by 7K, but they just need to get to the 42K mark so they can get their marksmen online, especially for Sans. He's been farming very, very hard, but it's important that both Keyboy and as well as CW get their own items to really make the difference in these upcoming team fights.
Yeah, I think this is where we can actually speak a little bit about the drafts. I feel like if they picked up the Yi Sun Chen, it would be much better to get that utility all across the board. Getting that vision is going to be crucial, especially in this kind of situation. But let's just see what happens here. Sans will be able to get that purple buff with the help of his team, but 20 seconds left right now for the Lord to spawn, and it is going to be an enhanced Lord. Onyx Philippines, they will have the pressure here. What does Onyx Esports need to do?
Well, I think Onyx Esports, they just need to breathe. They understand that this first Lord is going to be the most difficult one to actually obtain. So if they can defend this out and drag this game out, they know for a fact that they scale much harder compared to Onyx PH. Onyx PH, completely opposite. They want to wait for the Luminous Lord. They want to ensure that they can at least get one inhibitor turret and look to end the game with this lead and give them the best advantage possible.
Yeah, already the Larski and Boleski with the Zona, right? This is Onyx Philippines getting the Lord so easily.
Uncontested, you can say there. Onyx Esports, they didn't know what to respond with. They tried to go for a trade. They tried to go for the contest, but in the end, the zoning from the side of Onyx PH, and they just beautiful decision making to focus in, to commit into that Lord. It is going to come up for Onyx Philippines now with the Enhanced Lord marching down that top side.
I beg to defer. I think Onyx Esports, they're seeing that the Sonar is already coming up and they decide it's just not worth the resources to commit to this. And especially since this is the first Luminous Lord, I don't think they're that worried about clearing things up. They just need to make sure an inhibitor turret doesn't go down.
14 minutes, 2 Athena shield picked up. they still on time for this next clash, which is really instrumental for Onyx Philippines. Mm-hmm. Let's see how it goes. The third one.
Holy Baptism connecting onto Boots, going in. Not a lot of damage has been placed to either of the teams right now. It is going to be CW looking for a flank. Goes into the backside, unable to get anything done. It is going to be the Thorn Rose picked up, but the Lord has been taken down. Onyx Esports now with the defense. Will they be able to pull off a miracle here? Maybe even come back against the Filipino representatives. It is just going to be Onyx PH rotating to the mid lane, getting that tier 2 and being happy with it.
Yep, this is perfect. This is exactly what Onyx Esports wants. They know their timings. They know that no matter how much of a lead that Onyx PH has, as long as they are still in this game, they have hope to scale.
And I do agree with that because of the fact now that they have Drian on this Matrix, and you know that there's a ton of wave clear on Drian from long distance. You have the rockets, you have the machine gun as well. And if you're looking at Sans, can also sit back, go for the ultimate play. Use your ultimate to your advantage is what I'm trying to mean. Mm-hmm. And Onyx Esports, if they just continuously just defend against Onyx PH, this lead, it will not matter much. Because there will come a point where the lead, even if it's like 10k or 12k, if it's at like 18 minutes, it won't matter as much. You still have your lucked items out. And Onyx Esports, I think they have now 4 Athena Shield, mm-hmm. which kind of, you know, is a problem for Onyx Philippines because they now have to take the fight outside of the Onyx Esports base.
Yeah, I mean, this is the exact plan. Like, now Onyx Esports can comfortably turtle up and just say, hey, it doesn't matter how much of a lead, it really doesn't matter at the end of the day. And Onyx PH has to answer the bigger question. How do we break open this inhibitor turret on that top side? How do we get ourselves this big advantage? Because you can see, as you mentioned, Wolf, Drian, he's just whipping out Ben and is like, okay, send something. Oh, wait, hold on! They're already looking for the engagement!
Look at that, actually, Keyboy gets in and gets the Terror's Revenge on the two members, but there's just no follow from the side of Onyx Esports. They need to be able to defend. Kyrie jumps in back and forth, trying to deal some damage, but it is going to be the inhibitor turret falling down in the top side. Onyx ID on full defense mode now. With one inhibitor turret down, it is going to cut their, you know, their rotations even more here. It's going to be really, really hard for them to look for any kind of plays. It is also the Lord spawning in 60 seconds.
60 seconds, that's more than enough time for CW to get back into the game, but the Philippines just caught Indonesia kind of slacking there. Mm-hmm. You don't see that very often. And for CW, he's definitely like, okay, I gotta be a little bit more aware of the positioning. I cannot afford to give another one of these kills away.
Yeah, that's really the problem with you having so many scaling heroes on your side. You kind of feel that you need to get out, I need to get some farm, and that's what CW tried to do. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Unfortunately, he's gonna meet the brunt of Onyx Philippines. And this will also mean that the dirt up top is opened up. That means that Onyx Philippines will have a little bit of a lane advantage. All they have to do now is to let the lanes flow from both the bottom and the mid lane, and now they can control the Lord area.
I think this is interesting because CW, is he trying to build a Hunter Strike on Paquito so far? Doesn't their team kind of have more than enough damage at this point in time?
Yeah, but then again, if you're a gold lane Paquito, you want to deal the damage. So it's a big dilemma on the side of Onyx Esports. Should you just consider CW as your second XP laner, mm-hmm. and then put Drian on more on a damage per second kind of role, right?
Yeah, it's tough, but based on what we saw from the TikTok live cam on this Luminous Lord, Onyx PH, they want this fight. They're baiting Onyx into it. It's like, yes, come to us. And CW, he is able to face check it. He gets out of there no problem whatsoever, but that's what we're talking about. That sonar from the Philippines making it tough for Onyx Esports to really make a very clear decision about this Luminous Lord.
They are contesting for this, though, Gideon and Wolf. I feel like this is the calm before the storm, man.
Yeah.
This might be the final Lord for any of the teams, right? If Onyx Philippines lose this team fight and get wiped out, it is very possible for Onyx ID to come back from this. But we'll have to see what happens here. Kyrie dashes forward, gets some damage onto Keyboy. Sans is still able to kite away with the entropy, but look at that. They are one member short. Onyx ID has had to basically move Drian to that top side to be able to withstand the damage, but it's going to be Keyboy caught in a bad situation in the bottom side. Gets chunked to half HP. Now, the health bars and the resources, many of the abilities have been used up. We'll see what happens as of this moment. It is still the calm before the storm. Both teams just poking at each other.
Yeah, they got to reset. For Onyx Esports, they're at a clear disadvantage here. Drian has to go back up to clear up that waves time and time again. But Onyx PH were hovering around this Luminous Lord for so long that Kyrie was getting chunked out by this Lord, and he doesn't want to be anywhere close to lethal HP to get one shot by Onyx Esports.
Onyx Philippines, they're trying to burst this down with Beatrix coming down as well. It will mean that Onyx Esports have just been split up the map. They need to be doing so many things at once. It's gonna be the damage coming in. Boots gets instantly taken down. Sans jumps in with Entropy. Does not deal enough damage. Hatred jumps onto him. But look at T-Boy! The Tyrant's Revenge gets the kill. The Lord is still up for grabs. Will they be able to take it? It's gonna be the steal! Oh my god! Onyx Indonesia with the comeback. 4-2 and the Lord goes to Indonesia.
Give it to Keyboy. Give it to Keyboy. It was looking so Filipino favorite in that fight, but Keyboy turns it around, catching two and helping Andrian getting the Lord at the same time. Kyrie could only do so much.
My goodness, Keyboy, what a wonderful play. By the way, good peeling coming up from Onyx Esports.
Huge.
Even if you say that Boots, his argument, he might have said, but that wasn't really the case.
Wait a minute, the dead timers are gonna be enough. The predictions! And Onyx ID, they've come back, it's over! Onyx ID with the first win here in the M3 World Championships, day number 2. Oh. What a beautiful, and I really mean beautiful game of Mobile Legends.
Yeah, that was honestly, it really was amazing. We did get to see two very different styles here. It's not like, oh yeah, we're twin brothers. No, these are just stepbrothers. They're looking at each other. They know exactly what they want to do, but they have very clear identities and different priorities on how they want to play this game. I got